Alright guys, today I'm doing an unboxing. I got two snakes that came in today from Dynasty Reptiles. And if you haven't looked at their stuff, go check them out. They have such a huge variety of ball pythons, and then they also have rat snakes and king snakes as well. So today I got two snakes. Let's see. And the ball python. Luckily, it looks like she made it. She's wrapped up in a ball, but she appears to be alive. The poor rat snake I got did not make it. He was overnighted. The packaging seems to be well. He's in a little box. My only guess is he might have gotten a little too hot with the heat pack in there. But he was a pretty little snake, as you can see. But the poor guy didn't make it, so we'll have a little burial for him. But you can see this beautiful ball python I got. Oh, there she is. She's coming out to say hello. But we're gonna go ahead and get her in her little rack and let her settle for a day, and then we'll see if she'll take. All right guys, so I just wanted to show y'all the Caiman enclosure. I have Hans and Klaus, the two Caiman that are going in here. They're both about 20, 21 inches. And this enclosure is 4 foot wide by 4 foot tall by 8 foot long. So it'll work for them for probably another few years before they'll outgrow it, and then I can put somebody else in there. Next, I'll probably put a water monitor in there, like sub-adult water monitor. But for now, this would be a good place for them. So I wanted to show you the cage, what all went into it, about how much it cost. So I started to keep track of my receipts, but once I got to the $600 point, I said, you know, I'm not gonna track this anymore. I'm just gonna do it right. But I'll kind of show you about how much things cost and where you could cut corners if you wanted to do a similar setup. And then next, coming up, I have the green anaconda cage I'm gonna work on, which is also gonna be 4x4x8. I'm gonna have the big tegu cage, 4x4x8. Then I'm gonna have a smaller yellow anaconda cage to work on, and another arboreal cage to work on, which is gonna be a boyfriend for Bendy. A little carpet python I'm getting. So I'm super excited about that. And that should be about all the projects I have going on right now. But it's been super nice to have this quarantine time, because I've actually been busy every day from about 7 in the morning to 8, 9 o'clock at night, working with all my animals, working on new cages, cleaning, feeding, and all that good stuff. So I've had lots of time to spend with my animals, and it's just something I love and enjoy so much. And these past 3 weeks or so, I've just been happier than I've been in a long time. So stay tuned to see what all goes into this, and see if it's something for you that you might want to build. I've learned to let go. All right, so first I wanted to go over the main structure. I didn't want to take any shortcuts. I used the more expensive products. I used oak plywood, which is about $50 a sheet out here. So that kind of added up quick. I had to use 4 sheets of oak. So that was 200 bucks right there. And then plus all the other boards that I used, the braces, and then any scrap I had, I think I spent right at $300 on the wood, which isn't bad. So I thought, you know, this isn't gonna be too big of a project. I can do it for $500 or $600. Well, then my next trip to Lowe's, I grabbed a couple little things, like these little vents, a few more pieces of wood, some stain, some urethane, and some of these styrofoam sheets you see right here. And then a couple bags of the gravel, the sanded grout, excuse me. Sanded grout for the background, and then I urethaned over that. So at that point, I was at like $700, and I just said, you know what, I'm not even gonna have a budget with this. I'm just gonna do it how I want and make it look good and do everything right. So after that, and keep in mind, I'm not done yet. So I still have some little things to clean up. I still have to add a couple more lights, but you know, the majority of it's done, enough for me to show you guys and you get a good idea of what's going on. So I was originally gonna do sliding glass doors. Well, I was about 1/16 off from side to side. So as you can see, I kind of sanded right here. I have to stain that. But that kind of messed my idea up for sliding glass doors. So I figured, you know what, this is a big enough cage. I'm gonna fix this side. So this side is fixed with a track. I have to clean up the glue. But it's tracked and sealed. And then on this side, I'll have a sliding glass door over here. Well, the other piece of glass I had broke. And that is, let's see, 1/2 inch. I believe it's 1/2 inch. 1/2 inch by 48 by 48, or a little bit bigger to add up for the overlap. But somewhere around that size. But that was about $100 for those two pieces. And I broke one on the move. So for now, I'm just using a metal screen to keep them in for a few days. I'll probably put them in here tonight. But nextly, we had all the time, and this was experimentation for me, all the time that went into this background. And it's definitely not perfect, but I mean, it doesn't look horrible. It does the job. And from afar, it looks nice. You don't really see the defects until you start looking close. But I used a torch, like a butane torch, to burn the little marks you see to make it look like stone. And then the one thing I wish I would have done differently, I put the foam filler in here, the expandable foam used for like door cracks, stuff like that. And that really stands out. And I tried to carve it a little bit, but I just said, you know what, I'm just gonna put the grout over it and urethane over that and call it a day. Because at that point I had so many hours into doing this background. I mean, I didn't keep track, but I was working on it every day after work. Probably 20, 30 hours total into this. And at some point I said, this doesn't need to be, you know, the main focal point. It's nice to have a good background, but you know, it's not serving any purpose. And it does help, you know, a little bit with insulation, holding that heat in. But anyway, if I had to do it differently and to save a good bit of money, I would put just sheets up and burn them, and you get the same effects. You could burn lines and make it look like it was stone meeting. So next, I urethaned the roof. I sealed all the cracks. I put this foam on. I used silicone for that too, like a mold resistant. I can't remember the brand, but it's non-toxic mold resistant silicone. So after I got that done, I went over to the Tractor Supply store. I got one of these Rubbermaid. Gosh, I think this is a 75 gallon. It is like 50, I want to say 58 inches by 36 inches. and like 15 inches tall or something like that. So it's plenty big for them. I mean, especially since they like water and land. You know, the smooth front and Cuviers, they spend a lot of time on land. But I wanted to have a big enough water feature for them to swim around in and hunt and do all that good stuff. So I got this little fountain, and it's adjustable. Right now it's on low. It's only coming about, I don't know, a few inches out of the water. But it's also a filter, and I got it off of Amazon for like $19, and it's working really well so far. The water's still settling, but it's looking pretty good. Now I keep the water on about 84, 86 degrees. If it's in that range, then I'm happy. These lilies, those are fake. They sold real ones just like that, but I just went with the fake ones. Let's see. I used moss, that sphagnum moss, for the edges, just to kind of give it a little decoration and to hide the edge. I was gonna do stone all the way around like this, but I wanted to leave a little bit of it uncovered. So I did the stone over here, and that's also foam that I covered in grout, and use sanded grout. I learned that because it gives it more texture and makes it look more real. So sanded grout and urethane to kind of seal it. It's the same thing people will make hides out of for like bearded dragons and all that good stuff. And they hold up really well. They're lightweight, and it's like concrete when you're done. But you have to do a couple layers of the grout. I think I did 3 or 4 layers, and then 3 or 4 layers of urethane as well. But next, I just kind of did little touch-ups with the sphagnum moss all around the cage just to decorate it. And then I got this branch from my brother-in-law's house, and it works perfect for a basking spot. You can see I zip-tied it to the tub so it doesn't fall on them. But I'm gonna hide all that and put some moss over it, make it look nice. And then let's see. Once I put the tub in, I got that expandable spray foam, and I sprayed all behind it, all back here, and all around the sides, because these dudes love to hide. They'll get in any little crack and crevice you leave for them. So I covered all that up, and then I put silicone on top of that, and then put some sand down there just to make sure they couldn't get back there, because they love to get in the tightest little spots possible. After that, I came in and I put a layer of sand down in the whole cage. So the whole bottom is sand. And I put like 3 or 4 coats of the water-based urethane on the bottom board to seal everything up, to make sure it lasted, you know, a good while before it started warping or water got through and run the wood. Also, that oak wood is really good, but the urethane will help a lot. And I mean, if this cage lasts me 6, 7, 8 years, I'll be happy with that. I would feel like I got my use out of it. Of course, I would want it to last longer after all the money and time you put into it, but for being the first big cage I've built, I would be happy if I got that much time out of it. So after that, I got some natural soil and put that over it. And then I got some of that peat moss, the natural 100% organic, whatever, peat moss. And then I put a few of these little plants in, and they love to hide, so this will be good little places for them to hide and go burrow in. I'm probably gonna have to get another bag of soil and then some more cypress. But for now, this gives you an idea of what it'll look like. His name is Thanos, and I did get him from a show, and he is farm bred. So he's been doing well so far. We've had him for about 6 months with no issues. Waking up, trying to get his senses going. No? Look at that belly. He had some chicken last night. This ball python looks like this large mouse. He's on rats, but oh, look at that. Wait. Now why would you house two ball pythons together? He took it. Well, they were housed together as babies and we've tried to separate them and they would not eat and they just, their disposition and personality completely changed. So we put them back together, they went back to eating, and that's pretty much it. Do I recommend housing ball pythons together? No. And these are two males and they seem to be friends if that's possible. A little snake room decor. I need to finish decorating, but I have that. And this Harley Quinn pop art. And the fire extinguisher. I have my little shelves with my snake hook. My alligator head. Which you can find at just about every gas station in Louisiana. My favorite sign. And this antique trout that was stuffed by my dad's dad. And then one of Cooper's sheds wrapped around that. He says, oh, where are we? We have some crickets in here. I'm just knocking out, put it in there. So you can see he loves to hide. That's the first thing he did is went and hid. Gigi wanted to get a quick shot being majestic. As you can see, he could definitely be cast in Zoolander. Oh, blue still. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab them and we're gonna get them put in there and see what happens. All right guys, first we have Klaus. And yes, I'm wearing a glove. These guys look small. They're only about 20 inches, but they are strong. Remember, they're dwarfs. So what they lack in size, they make up for in power. And his little teeth, they'll slice right through you. One got me on my thumb and it just cut through it like paper, right down through my nail. So that's why I wear gloves. I don't want to get bit and get an infection because I have bad luck, and that is 100% something that would happen to me. So why not just put a glove on and look like a big poodie? So I'm gonna go ahead and release him in there. I'm gonna set him in the water and see what he does. You know what? Set him on. So he seems to be enjoying it. I put him on a little basking shelf and he's just sitting there. He's got his mouth open, so I think he's still ready to go. But I think he'll enjoy it once he leaps off into the water and he has this limb right here. He can climb up. So. Next, we're gonna do Hans. Hans is a little bit bigger, and I have my hand around his neck just so he can not whip around and freak out, because once they start waggling their tail, their little 2 foot long thing turns into a gator. But my fingers are literally just looped around. They're not even hardly touching his neck. So I'm not squeezing his neck. He's not in any harm. I love these animals and I take good care of them. But you can say his teeth are more gnarly. Look at that. And he just looks like a little demon. Look at his eyes. I've always been so fascinated with these. I actually didn't discover the Cuvier's Dwarf Caiman until, gosh, probably 6 years ago or so. And, that's when I knew I had to have one day. They just look like they mean business. And like I said, they're such a strong species. I mean, this little guy, if I'm not paying attention and holding onto his tail, he'll whip out of my hands. So, oh, he's probably about 21 inches right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and put him in the water. He usually likes to hang out there. So they seem to enjoy it. I'm not sure about how much they like the fountain with the movement of the water. They're not used to that. Usually I have a smaller filter, but I think they'll get used to it. So all I have to do to finish this enclosure for now, I'll probably come back and do a little more decor things, but add two more lights and that'll be about it. I'm sure over the time, over a couple weeks, I'll look and say, you know, I want to do this, I want to do that. And see, Thanos already took one of his mice, so he will not eat in front of me. Little Ajax here. He got some rosy red minnows today, but he doesn't seem to be interested. He had some chicken last night, so his little belly is full. Hans and Klaus seem to be getting settled in. Klaus found a nice little basking spot. Hans went over to check him out, see what was happening. I wanted to show y'all this green berm I have. I don't think I even have any pictures of her on Instagram. I've just been kind of keeping her sheltered, but she is super pretty. I'm pretty sure she just got out of shed. She's still super feisty. She's, let's see, I think she's coming up on a year old in June or July. So she's still got that little pissy berm attitude, but they always grow out of it quick. So you can see, and she's even lighter colored in person. So I'm hoping one day to breed her. Also have her as a pet. I get everything with the intention of a pet, but man, I can imagine her babies paired with a pearl would be very pretty. A little stink pot turtle my parents found in their house, and he loves to climb up on that little fountain and bask. Sometimes he'll be up in the corner with his little body vertical. But these guys are also known as musk turtles, but I always called them stink pots growing up. A little arboreal cage I'm working on for Bendy, the little carpet python. This is my little workstation, so it's a mess. And I'm using my work table for the Nile monitor cage, so I just have it put on a piece of plywood on top of a storage bin. Anyway, so right now I'm just waiting on this little shrimp piece to dry that goes over the acrylic. And these are just to support it while it dries. This bottom brace, waiting for it to dry, and then I'm gonna put a top one in so she can't push. And then the sides, I'll probably leave like they are, but I still have to finish this cage. With the inside just about done, I just have to add a little LED light and some heat. So after I finish that, she'll hopefully be in this cage by, let's say, Friday. Today's Tuesday. That'll give everything time to air out and be finished. All right, guys. Gigi wanted to be in the outro. So thanks so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share if this is your first time. I plan on doing a lot more videos. What do you have to say? He just likes to hang out and see what's going on. This is something I really enjoy doing. And like always, I would love to do it for a career. So, we'll just kind of see what happens. I'm going to continue at it. I don't quit easily, so I'm going to keep working on it and see what happens. Next, for vlog number 3, I plan on doing a walkthrough of each enclosure and the animals in the enclosures. So right now I have about, let's see, as far as reptiles go, I probably have about 30 reptiles. So we'll kind of go through and
look at the cages and talk about what's in the future for these animals I have. And I love building cages, so I want to have a bunch of very impressive cages, like a, you know, kind of thugging on a budget. Not zoo cages in particular, but for a private collection, you know, something semi-impressive that people can come and see and enjoy the animals and the enclosure that they're in and appreciate that they have plenty of space and everything they need. So a lot of these snakes, like the big berms, people always get surprised. So you have an 8 or 9 foot berm in an 8 by 3 by 3 cage. Well, these berms, they actually just eat and then they'll go coil up in the heat and just absorb all that. They'll drink a lot while they're digesting the food, just to help break it apart. And they'll pee and usually digest that rabbit or whatever in about, from my experience, about 10 to 12 days on a bigger meal, like a, let's say a 6 or 7 pound rabbit. So they're not super active. I take them out every few days to kind of roam around the warehouse and they enjoy that. But even whenever I let them out, they'll often just go find the darkest corner and they'll just hide right there. So they're not like lizards or something that need to have more space and that, like little Gigi here, that just seem to use their brains more. I'm not saying berms are stupid by any means, but I'm saying if you compare it a berm to a, you know, Asian water monitor or even a little bearded dragon, you know, it wouldn't even be close. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share, and stay tuned for the next video.